I started building model rockets when I was about 9 years old. My brother and I built a whole fleet of them, including one that would actually take aerial photos. We also built a telescope that we took out and we used it to sketch the features on Mars during its close approach. Little did I know that 40 years later, I'd be actually sending a camera to the surface of Mars. I've always been interested in space. Here at LANL, I have the opportunity to work with brilliant scientists and engineers to really explore the final frontier. I came to Los Alamos 15 years ago, and back in the late 90s, LANL was involved in several space projects that I got to be a part of. So I actually got to lead the instrument development on NASA's Genesis mission, which was the first mission to return from beyond the moon. Within a few months of my arrival at LANL, a colleague in the chemistry division invited me to a demonstration in his lab. When I came in the door, I started noticing that the filing cabinets had marks which looked a little bit like acne on a filing cabinet, and I learned later that they were really laser divots. Well, he took me into this laser lab. I could see a small laser, in fact it was this laser, and it was set up to fire at a rock across the room. And he turned it on, he powered it up with a little 9-volt battery and pressed a button. An invisible beam shot across the room, and with that he turned on a spectrometer and showed me what elements were present in this rock. And when I saw this and how it worked on such little power and such a small laser, I said, this has to fly someday. Over the next few years, we teamed up with about 20 space instrumentation specialists here at the lab. We also aligned ourselves with a group in France, and together we developed what became the flight version of the experiment we saw in the lab earlier. And we decided to call this instrument ChemCam. NASA selected ChemCam to go on the Curiosity rover. It's a one-ton behemoth, about the size of a car. And this will travel around on the surface of Mars while ChemCam shoots rocks to analyze their composition and transmit the data back to Earth. Last year I went to Florida with my family to watch it launch towards the planet that I have loved since I was a boy.
All right, go, go, go!
Curiosity lands in August. Everyone's going to be watching Mission Control at JPL, where I'll be biting my nails, watching as the thing comes down, hoping that it lands safely, so that ChemCam can reveal the secrets of the Red Planet, so that we can know what it's like for humans to go there someday.